Howdy y'all, and welcome to Lex Lives. I think it's time we play a little Infotech 2. Alright. So, I just finished putting the last of my glycerin out. So now I need. Is it oxygen I'm putting in here? I need more, is the problem. So I need to make more. No, it's nitrogen. It's nitrogen I'm putting in here, right? You'd think I could remember for the 2 seconds it's been. Yeah, there we go, nitrogen. All right. So that's gonna make us glycerin. And so we gotta make two types of explosives. We gotta make the powder barrel. Which is wood, string, and gunpowder. How much gunpowder do I have? I feel like I probably don't have a lot. That's how much gunpowder I have. Not a lot. Not enough for this quest, that's for sure. I don't know why I'm looking in all those places. Is there a way to make gunpowder? Not wood. I know I've got wood. Gunpowder. Yes. Yes, there is. Sulfur, coal, and saltpeter. I don't know if I have any saltpeter. Oh, you can also make it with coal and redstone. All right. Well, that's doable. Oh, look, you can get it from pulverizing a powder barrel. You can get it from bees. Okay, so I want what was that? It was redstone and coal powder. Redstone. And how much do you get for that? So I can figure out how much I gotta make here. Three. So you get three. My quest says I need to make six. You get one. I've got enough for one, so I need five more. So 5 times 4 is 20. 20 divided by 3 is about 7. It's gonna have to be 7 for us. So I need 7 times 4 is 28 coal dust. Alright, well, I got 18 right there. And there's another 8. That gives me 26. What did I say I needed? 28? Let's see. Coal dust, right? Nope, that's stibnite. Dang it, what about that? Ilmenite, silicon, carbon. It's charcoal. Coal dust, right there. There we go. Man, isn't that handy? I've got coal dust all over the place for me. And then I'm gonna need 5 times that amount in redstone. Which I apparently don't have any. I've got redstone dust on me. So I need five. I need 35 redstone. I've got that on me. We're good. We're good. Okay, so it's redstone, redstone, redstone. And then coal dust. Romp. Okay. And then Gunpowder. With three left over. Look at that. I might need gunpowder for the next part, too. I don't know. And then I need string, it says. I've got 11 string. Okay. And then I need wood. Do I have any just wood already made up? I might have some in my crafting bench here. I do. Okay. All right, and then string. Okay, there's my six barrels. Six powder barrels detected. And then the dynamite uses the chemicals that I was making. Dynamite. And that is paper and string with the glycerol trinitrate. Paper. I think I've got a bunch of that made up here somewhere. Or I've got four. One of the two. Really? Is that all the paper I've got? I feel like I was using paper for something. Yeah, right there. And I'm surprised this is all the paper I've got. Making paper seems to me is something mildly tricky. Paper. I think this is the way I was making it with oh, you can do it with sugarcane too. Okay. Sugarcane and water and a chemical bath. Dang it, really? Because my chemical bath is currently in use. As my. Oh, that's not my chemical bath. That's a chemical reactor. Oh. Those are also chemical reactors. I don't have a chemical bath currently hooked up. Interesting. I think I've got one. Nope, your fluid solid canning machine. I think I've got one here somewhere. Chemical bath right there. Let's get you hooked up to some water and power here if we can. I think that stuff is all in use at the moment. Where's my fluid conduit? What are you, arc furnace? You're not gonna even want to attach to that. Yet a wrench. Get that switched over. There we go. I don't think the arc reactor will pick up that water. Yeah. You will, though. And then let's go grab some sugarcane. Man, you are coming in really handy lately, guy. My little sugarcane farm I got going here. Dude, I need more sugarcane than that. I'm gonna go across over here though and bust up your friend. I'm gonna need more than that. I need. I need one sugarcane per paper, and I'm gonna need 16 papers. So I've got. Oh, how much paper got on me? So 11, so I need 5 more sugarcane then. I need 11 sugarcane. Sugarcane. Really? There's some. I was gonna say, nobody's got any sugarcane around here. What the heck? Thank you. I need more than that. I need two more sugarcane. There's some. I kinda wanna see where this river goes now. Big, big. This is a pretty far flowing river here, actually. Man, look at all that sugarcane right there. I am kind of surprised at how far out here this river is going. This is impressive. Usually rivers kind of just run out, and this one just keeps going and going. It's the Energizer Bunny of rivers. That's a big creepy hole. And that big creepy hole is where, well, I guess it didn't technically run out, but now it did. Sort of. Maybe it just went around the corner here. Yeah, it just went around the corner. Wow, how big is this river? Huh. It's huge. That river goes everywhere. Look at that. Look at my road. All right, where are we at, anyways? That's not where we're at. So I need to go north. North. I think this is north. Ways directions is north. I don't know. I need to go into my map and change the settings so I can see that. Mini map. And I want compass font scale. Bring that up a notch for me. There we go. Now I can see where the little letters are on the edges. Help me find my way home. That made me think of Quantum Leap. Hoping each jump will be this jump home. Ooh, you know, we should check the potato levels while we're here. Still plenty of potatoes to power things. I've got vodka-powered generators. All right, so you need to make me some paper. And while we're doing that, I need to go down and get some wool so I can get some string. White sheeps. How much space do I have? Yeah, I might as well grab black sheeps while I'm down here, and then I can throw that into the cutter. It's not like I'm not going to be using more tin cable eventually here, right? And then I'm going to need the carter. Or whatever it's called on here. The. Oh, where are you, you weird little hand tool? There you are. A wool gin. Alright, so now we've got plenty of string, since I only need 16, and plenty of paper into my chemical reactor. Okay, paper and string. Oh shoot, but the glycerin needs to be in where the water is. Oh, yeah. That makes things a little trickier. Okay, let's do this. I can do this. I can. First, I need a tank. Do I have a tank in here anywhere? I remember I made a bunch of tanks when I was playing with oil. There we go. I think these hold 16. Let's grab two just in case. I need a little bit of room in here to work on this. So I'm going to. Okay, I'm going to disable that one. And okay, and then we're going to disable that one. And then this is where it's going to get tricky. I don't want that filled with water, unfortunately. It filled with water. Well, it's a good thing I brought two. Okay. So I want you to output. Oh, that only holds eight. All right, let me go grab another tank then, since I accidentally got some water in this one. You can have the water one. I want an empty one. Actually, give me two just in case. Pipes, man, they're tricky. Oh, there's way more trinitrate in there than I thought. Yeah, we just hit eight now. Get a little faster here, guys, all right? All right, and then I can take this. Smack that 13 times. Okay, and then we turn off fluid auto, and then we swap this to insert. Oh, yes, and I gotta change the direction on this. No? Nothing yet? Well. All right. So now you're making me TNT. Or dynamite, I guess. Alright, and then this guy should be making potions slowly. Got a couple more here. Three more potions to make. Of that kind. And then I've got to, change things around. Right now, I think it's running through the fermenter. And so I'm getting potions of slowness, which I need 10 of, and then once I get those 10 made from the fermenter, I can take the fermenter out of the whole deal, and we'll be good there. I feel like this is why are we stopping? Why are we stopping? Hello? What the heck? Okay, it was me. It was me. I had it screwed up. I'm sorry. It was me. Okay, we'll let that make the TNT then. And you're still doing potions, so we're good there. All right, so what comes up next when we're done with our TNT here? That was the potions, that was the TNT. We've got the scanner down here, a basic scanner. Came across strange floral and fauna all the time. I have no idea how to determine if they have useful traits to fix this. I need a decent scanning machine to analyze things. The scanner can be used to scan and analyze the items, give you more information about them. It'll also be fundamental once you begin investigating the futuristic replication process, when you will scan a material you want to replicate into data orb. Sounds cool. All right, what goes into a scanner? Scanner. Whoa. We need good electronic circuits for that. Ooh, man. Four of them. Wait, was that just... That's just an electronic circuit with some more NAND chips. That's not even a big deal. I can handle that. How you guys doing down here on plastic? Oh, you've gotten none. How am I doing on electronic circuits then? I've only got eight. Oh man, I didn't realize. Oh, but you have plenty of stuff. You just need some oxygen cells in there. That I can handle. Give me some more plastic sheets going, ma'am. There we go. TNT. TNT. That's my inventory. Very full of weird things. Okay. TNT. TNT quest is done. Okay, so we got coin bag, component bag. I like the component bags. Oh, I can't, though, because I don't have enough room. Okay, let's get back down here. String cables. Oh, you know what? I had some issues with my cabling, and I have switched my cables out down here to 8x10 cable. Because everything I put in here keeps burning up. I don't know. I mean, I understand why it would burn up, but it's weird that it burns up to me. Like, I had times two aluminum in there. I had 10 in there. I had something else in there. They all got burnt up. So I have switched over to the 8x10 because everything else just gets burnt up, and I had 8x10 laying around. So, yeah, that was crazy. So we got some dynamite now. I'm gonna go see this dynamite in action. Do you think I need like a flint and steel to set this stuff off? Do I have a flint and steel somewhere? I feel like I probably do. I mean, it's easy enough to make, right? We're gonna make dynamite. I want to see it explode, all right? Yeah, there we go. Flint and steel. Where should we go explode it? I know. Let's go back over here where I already have destruction. And let's see how this stuff works. This is where I get myself blown up by myself, right? So, dynamite looks like something I would throw. Oh yeah, right click. It didn't seem like a very big explosion. But you can throw it, so that's cool. What kind of ore is that? That's a barite, right? Yeah, dynamite's kind of tiny. We'll throw it in there. Be like a dive bomber. I feel like the one I threw in the water. I'm pretty sure the one I threw in the water just made bubbles. That's funny. Oh, see, it went in the water. It did. It just made bubbles and then disappeared. Aw, poor little dynamite. Alright, let's try this other one here. A powder barrel. Now, this is supposed to be the more simplistic way. Okay, that's a bigger explosion, I think. That was weird, though, that it didn't go. It kind of just stopped on me there. Like, it's lit. It's going. It's going. I just launched a chicken straight up into the sky. It's dead now. Yeah, definitely bigger explosions with the powder barrel. That's interesting. We'll shove it in a hole here and see what happens. I don't know if that lit. Okay, I'm pretty sure it lit. I'm afraid it's gonna hurt me. Okay. I don't think it's working. Okay, now it's got smoke coming out of it. No? What's it doing? There it goes. It's so bizarre that it takes multiple tries to get it to light. What if I put two down? I hope that one to go. Okay. let's shove it back in here and see how this works. I don't know if that actually, like, the ghost of TNT is falling out of that. Do you see that? There we go. Yeah. Powder barrel, definitely the way to go compared to little dynamite. Although maybe dynamite's more of a controlled explosion. Interesting. Alright, let's just get rid of the rest of that. Boom, boom. Alright, that was the TNT day, I guess. Now I'm out of explosions. It's kind of sad. I do like using explosives in here sometimes. Not for anything useful, you understand. Just, I mean, but in reality, what? I've got my laser, right? If I want explosions... okay, I can't remember how to do this. There we go. I was using my scroll wheel. If I want explosions, I mean, you know, I don't have a better way to do explosions, really, than this. I say I don't really use explosions, and then I made a giant trail using explosions. Ooh, what did I find with my explosions? Ow, ow, I almost died, I almost died. Alright. Let's get you back on long range here. Man, I haven't used my laser in a while. Lasers are fun. Alright, with that, I think I'm gonna go ahead and call it a day before I kill myself. It's happened before. yeah, so we got the TNT done. I'm gonna have to get some more circuits together, it looks like, which means I need to get my barrel of oil reattached over here and drained and probably refilled again. So let's get you planted down, get that oil flowing back where it's gonna do me some good. This guy here making me plastics. And then that way I can get back to work on some circuits. I gotta get some good circuits made for the scanner. And then we'll see where that goes from there. So click like if you like, subscribe to sure and catch the next one. And I will talk to you later.